When it comes to productivity apps, the calendar is at the heart of everything I do, and I use the poop out of my calendar. Yeah, this is a G-rated channel. Keeping track of my work and my wife who plays in an orchestra and her rehearsals, plus we have three kids involved in a bunch of activities, plus scheduling podcasts and recordings, and everything goes in the calendar. Plus, as my kids have gotten older, it's been helpful to share events with them so they know what's happening and where they're going to. So in this video, I want to share with you the calendar app that makes it all possible. And yes, I pay over $100 a year for this calendar app, but it has very specific features that lets me see the events I need to see, when I need to see them, and nothing else. Some of you may have guessed it already, but I use Fantastical on all my Apple devices, my iPhone, my Mac, my iPad, and yes, now Apple Vision Pro too. Everything from its design and its feature set, the widgets I can put on my home screen, everything about Fantastical makes it easy to get my work done. I'm gonna give you the top 7 reasons I use Fantastical everywhere and some ideas for helping you get organized with your events. So within Fantastical, I have multiple accounts syncing. I use my iCloud calendar for family, shared events, and some personal events, plus work calendars and others. One of the keys to this is my iCloud calendars that I do share with specific family members. I have personal calendars like events and leisure and appointments, and those are just for me. And then me, my spouse, and my kids have multiple calendars that are shared between different family members. I have a spouse calendar that's just for me and my wife, a family calendar that's shared with me, my wife, the kids, and grandparents. We have a school and events calendar. This way I can see where the kids are if they're on a field trip, but also a kids events, and this is shared specifically with their iCloud accounts so they can see their events as well. Now, because we have so many shared calendars across our family members, that can make some days on the calendar look a little intense. For instance, this day, which is a Thursday, there's lots of stuff going on, from guitar lessons to rehearsals in the evening to dinner at my mom's house. And seeing all these events throughout the entire workday for me is a little distracting. So the number one feature I love about Fantastical are calendar sets. Here you can create specific sets of calendars that will only show you calendars across multiple accounts. It can pull from your iCloud and your work calendars. And so when I go into work mode, I can just see the events that pertain to me. I enable my spouse calendar because if there's any events where both of us are involved in the evening, I like to know what time I need to leave the house. And then any events that have to do with podcast recordings or work, those are the only calendars I see. And a huge benefit of Fantastical is you can create these calendar sets and then you can automatically activate them at certain times of day. So I have my work mode calendar set activate every weekday at 7 a.m. This way I know I'm only seeing the calendars I want to see while I'm working. Likewise, I also have a calendar set called weekend. This is something that shows up both in the evenings and on the weekends. And my weekend calendar set, I don't have to see any of my work events during the week, but I still see events pertaining to the whole family. And I have my main calendar set, which has all the calendars that may pertain to anyone in the family wherever they are during the day. And because Fantastical is available on every platform, these calendar sets can activate across my Mac, my iPad, my iPhone, and whatever calendar set is active will also affect what appears in the widgets on my iPhone, which I'll show you the widgets in a minute. But my number two reason is those calendar sets that I program in Fantastical can actually be surfaced in focus modes on your iPhone. So for instance, my weekend focus mode, I can add a focus filter to just show my weekend calendar set in Fantastical. This way, if you want to schedule your calendar sets based on focus modes that you activate throughout the day or the week, you can do it either directly in Fantastical or manage it using a focus mode, which then syncs across all your devices as well. I'm big on focus modes. I'll actually put a video right up here that explains my process for that. But I have a focus mode called evening that activates every day around 6 p.m. when I'm done working. And for that, I can change my calendar set to my weekend calendar set, which then just shows me family events, things my wife and kids might be doing, but I don't have to see my work calendars during that time. Calendar sets and their integration with focus filters is a huge deal. Now, if you just use the stock calendar app, there are some focus filter options, but you have to individually select different calendars for every focus mode filter that you're creating. I much rather create a calendar set in Fantastical, and then I can use that set anywhere I want, including in focus modes. All right, number three, because we have multiple shared calendars, some with my kids, some with my spouse, sometimes we have duplicate events, but we do it on purpose. We want our kids to be able to see an event here, and I also want it on the spouse calendar because that's involved in certain calendar sets. Well, Fantastical has an incredible feature where I can tap and hold on any event, and then I can scroll down and just tap hide. Hiding an event means I can hide this event or all in the sequence, and it's not deleting the event, nor declining the event. Maybe you have a personal event with some information for an upcoming meeting that only you want to see, plus you have the meeting where you had to accept the invite. This is a great feature where you can hide one of the events, but it doesn't decline it and it doesn't remove it from your calendar. It just hides it from your view. This is a small feature, but when you're really using calendars and sharing it with different people, I find the hide event to be a key part of managing my view here in Fantastical. And speaking of different views, my number four reason is the design of Fantastical. I absolutely love the design, like being able to use swipe and use gestures to navigate. I can swipe on my event list to go between days. I can swipe on a specific event and get all those options like hide, duplicate, or edit an event. And if you use a Mac, one of the amazing features is having a calendar icon right here in the menu bar. I love the design of Fantastical here in the menu bar. I have my month view with all the little events as dots on the certain days, plus my agenda of events coming up, and everything looks amazing. They also give you lots of options for the icon or widgets. It follows your light and dark mode according to your system. And they also have an incredible watch app and widget, and there's tons of customizations there as well. And yes, like I mentioned, Fantastical is also on Apple Vision Pro and was there on day one. And I have to say, seeing your calendar huge in front of you, you can really see your schedule at a glance, you can manage your events, and you have all the powerful features of Fantastical in your Apple Vision Pro headset too. Fantastical also has really nice design touches where if you have a video call, like this is my Riverside recording tomorrow for Primary Technology, my podcast about tech, links down in the description to listen to that. I like seeing that little symbol, so I know what platform I'll be using to record that call. Likewise, they have icons for Microsoft Teams and Google Meet. And again, it's just one of those nice little design features that appear both in the app, and you can also see it in things like the Mac menu bar icon. And along with the amazing design, there's also a ton of customizations for Fantastical. For instance, I really prefer just seeing today's events instead of the entire agenda for the next several days. So I can jump into the Fantastical settings. I can choose whether or not to show the end times for events. I can show those hidden items, which I showed you previously. It has smart features like combining identical events or showing multi-day events in an all-day section. You can have options like showing the map for locations that are added to an event. So when you open it and see the details, you can see the location right there. And the way I like to view my events is when I'm looking at the list view, I like to see the selected day only. You can also choose selected day and next day. So if I have today selected in the month view up here, I can see today's events and tomorrow. You can also do all events if you want to be able to scroll down the list, but I like to see just today's events. This way it helps me focus on what's going on, and I can just think about the meetings or other activities I have coming up that day. Of course, Fantastical has a great event adding option. It uses natural language to parse new events. And of course, you can expand that and then add all the details to the event that you would like. If you're going somewhere for an event, I highly recommend using the location field. This way you can get an alert when you need to leave. The stock calendar does this too, but just so you know, Fantastical has it. And I won't go into all the settings, but as you can see, it is a robust feature set. If you want to see your tasks alongside your calendar, you can also enable that. And the tasks that you have in your reminders can show up here in Fantastical. You can do things like highlight weekends, which I like that view. This way it can subtly break out the weekend from your work week. And most importantly, if you are lawful good, you can start your week on Monday. Or, you know, if you're chaotic evil, you could start it like on a Wednesday or something. All right, number six, Fantastical has the best widgets for calendars. Lots of different sizes and shapes pulling in your different events, however you'd like to see it, small, medium, and large. My personal favorite, I like having the square calendar on my weekend home screen and my focus mode. This way I can just, at a glance, jump to a day. But the one I use on most of my home screens is this, which has the month view and the event list for that day all in one. Like I mentioned, it actually pulls from the calendar set you have active now. I can add an event just by tapping the plus icon right here. It does jump me into the Fantastical app, but since iOS 17 and interactive widgets, I can actually scroll through the months right here on the widget and not even jump into the Fantastical app. I can also see my event listing here on the left, and I can browse my events without ever jumping into the app. I can do it all right here from the widget. I can even tap on a specific day and it will jump to that day's events. Really powerful widgets, and if you have a large widget like this, it's like having a full calendar app right on your home screen. Typically, I put this in a widget stack along with weather at the top of my home screen. So when I'm in my normal work mode, I have my weather and I can just flip it up and see my events right there. Click on a day, go to another month, everything right here in the Fantastical widget. And if you want to use the Fantastical widgets right on your desktop on the Mac, you can do that too. You can add one of these large ones. You can put it in the today view or put it right here on your Mac desktop. I can put it in the top right corner, then add today's date, the calendar list with the heat map of events. I can click on a day to jump to it right here, or go back to today to see the list of events and click the plus button to add an event directly in Fantastical. And it fades away nicely when it's not active. All right, and number 7, Fantastical is great at little details. For instance, you can actually have the weather show up on your calendar. So right here, looking at tomorrow's agenda, I could see the weather, the high low of the temperatures. Yes, I live in Florida, so there's almost a 30 degree difference between the low and high. But you can see that everywhere here on the iPhone and iPad app as well. You can add your tasks in Fantastical, like I mentioned, and they're always adding new features like openings. If you had ever used a third-party service to open yourself up for scheduling meetings, Fantastical now has a feature built in called Openings, and you can do that all with your Fantastical account. You can open yourself up to a calendar set up meeting templates, and then send out times for someone to schedule with you all inside Fantastical. You can even customize how the badge appears on the application, like just showing today's events, or the current calendar week, or today's date. You can granularly control how alerts come through for different events and the default alerts. Fantastical also has great time zone support right here if you travel often. You can choose where you want to open links and maps directions. Just tons of customization options across all the platforms. And that's why it's more than worth it for me to pay over $100 a year for a calendar app. If you have any questions about my calendar setup or Fantastical, drop comments below this video. And if you want to see more productivity videos, maybe how I use Bear Notes app or how I organize my tasks in Notion, let me know. I'd love to do videos on that in the future as well. And if you want to learn more about shortcuts, which can really help automate your workflows, I'll put a playlist right up here. I have a shortcuts 101 video and even advanced shortcuts with more shortcuts videos coming soon. And if you want to learn a little bit more about Apple Vision Pro, I have several videos on that. I'll put one right up here. If you're curious, you know, what changed my mind about Apple Vision Pro to go from a skeptic to someone who likes it, I'll put that video right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.